We have said we want to show the rectilinear propagation of light. So what we shall need, at least three cardboards. This is the first cardboard, one. I'll need another cardboard, what? Two. I'll get another cardboard, what? Three. Then I'll be viewing from this side. Within those cardboards, I'll make holes which are of the same height. I'll put here one, two, three holes. What will happen? I'll need to look at, let's try to check. That's what I'm talking of. We have looked at our cardboards. One, two, three. So previously, before, there are three. Hope you can see that. That's what I was talking of. One, two, three. Get your source of light. Someone viewing at this point. Then when someone tries to displace, let's displace cardboard what? Number what? Cardboard number? Number two. Are you seeing at that point we are displacing? We are making it move up. At that point, our boy here called Oscar is no longer receiving light. Why do you think Oscar is not receiving light? Someone tell me, why do you think Oscar is not receiving light? Rays are being blocked by cardboard two. So if this is our source of light, it comes at passes here. Now let's try to make it move down. When you make it move down, what will happen? Light will pass through. So that's what we call the rectilinear propagation of light. Hope you are seeing our source of light. Yes? We have our source of light. We have an obstacle. Which type of obstacle is that? This is the formation of a shadow is the evidence that light travels through a straight line. Hope you see when it is blocked by an obstacle, there it is a shadow of the nail. Mine, you are seeing when I reduce the distance between the object and the screen, the shadow reduces. When I try to increase the distance between the object and the screen, it also increases. So that's how it varies. During night, when you go near the bulb, what happens to your shadow? Your shadow will be very big. Are we together? This marks to what we call a point source. It's just a point source as you are seeing one point there. And it will be forming a region which we call umbra. It is forming a region which we are calling umbra. Are you seeing that region of total darkness? Yes. That's what we call umbra. Then if we want to go to penumbra, let's go to the next slide. And we see a penumbra. The next slide tells us what? With an extended source. The shadow has regions of no light. And that is what? Umbra. And partial light. That is? Then it means, hope you are seeing the umbra and penumbra. Let's view it from your computers. I want us to see it from the computers. Straight from the computer. Everyone must be able to identify your umbra and the penumbra. Let's try to vary the distance and we see how the shadow is also going to be varying. Try to move. Hope you are seeing it's varying. Then when you try to notice that, there are two sources of light. That is an extended source. There is one point at the source, and there is another point at the source. Are we together at that point?
Yes.
There are two sources. There is one point, and there is another
point.
Try to vary the distance. Are you varying the distance?
Yes.
Is the shadow also varying or not?
It's varying.
Is it varying?
Yes.
The distance is varying. Then the size of the shadow is varying, the size of the umbra and the penumbra. So that one comes and it takes us to a point that Anambra is, that's the region of total darkness on a shadow. Then the penumbra, how do you define the penumbra? It's the region of partial darkness. When we talk of the eclipse, we don't talk of these things you get from your stories in the village, that the sun is fighting the moon is kicking the sun. No, it's not that. It's just an obstacle when we create a region. Now, when you try to visualize, we are having our sun, we are having our moon, and we are having our earth. Now, this moon is rotating. Are you seeing that? The moon is rotating, is orbiting around the earth. When it comes, let it come. The moon comes. When the moon comes, let it come. It comes, as we are seeing, it comes to that point. To that point, the moon will go between the earth and the sun. When it goes between the earth and the sun, it will create a region of umbra and a region of penumbra. Then those people on earth who receive the umbra region, for them they will just see it total darkness. It will just be total darkness. But those people who are going to receive the penumbra, what will happen? For them they will just receive some partial darkness. So don't keep on saying that the moon is fighting the earth, they are kicking, they are in the box. No, that's not true. It's just an obstacle. Hope you are seeing now the moon is blocking some part of the what? The earth. When it is blocking the light, which is coming from the what? When it's blocking the light which is coming from the sun, then it will just create a shadow on the earth with the two regions. The first region, the umbra region, and the second region, the penumbra. So it may be during the day, exactly like at 3 p.m. And what happens? The eclipse comes. Those people in the umbra region, they will see it as total. They will receive total darkness, however much it will be during day. Then the next eclipse, we looked at the next eclipse, not so? And we call it what? Lunar eclipse. Okay, now, as we have seen, let's come back. As we have seen, that there are things we have tried to learn, and if it wasn't digital science, we wouldn't have got them. For example, if it was a digital science, there is no way we are going to go and see the moon and the sun when we are having an eclipse. It has helped us a lot to visualize. What thing have you learned? Which new thing you have never seen and you have learned from digital science now? You have learned what? What have you seen there? Yes, Logos. You have learned?
We have seen the demonstration of light rays.
We have seen the demonstration of light rays. Which other thing have you seen? When you look at digital science, it helps us to visualize. At this point, we have looked at digital science as just a part, if you're a part of it. But also, we look at the virtual lab, where we shall look at the practical part of cyber technology. So, when you get time, when you get your time, you come, click on digital science or either virtual lab. So try to use digital science and virtual lab such that you memorize the concepts, which when we give you concepts, you memorize, you go to the quiz mode, test yourselves such that you can prosper in your exams. Thanks for attending the lesson. May the Lord bless you.
My name is Amnandaula Precious Hannah. I come from Light Secondary and Vocational School, Bulenga. I'm here to talk about the software called Cyber School. I started using it the moment I came to this school. It was in senior 2 first term, that's when I came, and I started using it. My best subject is biology, and that's why I used to go. The good things I've got from cyber, you know more things that you couldn't know in books. Yet they give us pictures, yes, but in cyber, you can check out what's the real image of it and how it is and how it is practiced. Like I can go and I check out the stem of a plant. They can give them to us in the books, in the diagrams, but when you're on cyber, you can check out very well and you see how it really looks, its color and everything.
My name is Namazi Angel from Light Secondary and Vocational School, Vulenga. I'm in senior 2A. I started using digital science and virtual lab when I came to this school. The thing I like about digital science is that suppose the teacher teaches me things in class and I go to the lab, I master them more easily because I see them physically.
As me, Mkisha Boaz, my studies are going well because of cyber school. Now, as I'm in class, the teacher can teach anything. I don't get anything unless I believe by seeing. Now, if I go in the computer lab, I go in the cyber, then I start looking. I go in biology, physics, chemistry, and any other subject, science subjects. Now, as I go in chemistry, I can mix chemicals, and I say that this one, if I mix this and this, I'll get this, and I believe it by seeing. The software of cyber school is better than going and see what they are teaching on the chalkboard, because they are my friends which are there when they also believe by seeing as I do.
What I have here is a document in regards to our cyber school technology solution for any information in regards to our software, that is digital science and virtual lab. The simplest way of having or helping a student learn science subjects. We have hundreds of teachers across the country acquiring the software, which is digital science and virtual lab, and also equipment like laptops being provided to those schools interested in this software. Of course, many thanks to the schools that have already managed to acquire the software itself. Green Hill Academy in there, Seroma Christian High School in Mokono. We also have Aga Khan High School, including Burenga Light Vocational School, and of course, New Horizon Secondary School in Mukona. It doesn't matter which part of the country, for as long as you're interested in the software, accessible via our main offices, that is in Lugogo Uma Showgrounds, that is in Cyber School Technology Solutions. Many thanks for the feedback on our Facebook and Twitter handle, that is CSTSUG, or our email address, that is info@cyberschooltech.co.ug. Till next time on Digital Science for You.